So previously, we saw this array of pointers and we allocated each element. I won't show you this. Let's printf %d and print array sub 0. So this is our first pointer. And then I want to dereference this pointer and get the first element that it is pointing to. So array sub 0 sub 0. This is just like when we were dereferencing the pointer like this. Okay? So we will print the element pointed to by this pointer. So let's, for example, set this element to be equal to 5 like this. So equals 5, build and run, and we have 5. Okay, now each pointer is pointing to one integer, right? Let's make each pointer point to two integers. The first element that this pointer is pointing to will be equal to 5, and now let's set the second element to be equal to 7. So we will do something like this. Put parentheses over here, and we are dereferencing this pointer and want to get to the second element, right? So plus 1, right? And over here, let's print, put here backslash n, and print the second element that this pointer is pointing to. Build and run, and as you can see, 5, 7. So you can imagine this as follows. Each pointer over here is pointing to an array. Now, if we continue adding elements, let me print this element over here. First, let's set it to be equal, for example, for 10. Let's print it, put a backslash n, build and run. And as you can see, 5, 7, 10. And look at this. This is just like a 2D array. This is the first row, and we are accessing the first element in the first row, then the second element in the first row, then the third element in the first row, right? And we can do the same thing with the second pointer, right? So this is a 2D array. So let's do the following. We are allocating for each pointer three elements in the memory, okay? So for int I equals 0, I is less than 3, and I plus plus, and let's change this for 2. So I want two elements for each pointer. So now I will iterate over the elements. So for int j equals 0, j is less than 2, and j plus plus. And over here, I will read these elements. So scanf, and normally we want to store them at array sub I sub j. Now copy this code, paste it, and let's print. So over here, let's say printf %d array sub I sub j. And of course, over here, we need the address. Okay, let's try it, build and run. So I'm imagining that I'm filling a normal 2D array that has three rows and two columns in each row. So this is my first row, this is my second row, and this is my third row. Let's see, perfect, 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8. Awesome. Let's add a backslash n, take this code, put it here, printf, backslash n, run the program. So 1, 2, 6, 7, 8, 0. Perfect, 1, 2, 6, 7, 8, 0. So we have a 2D array, right? Now, let's dereference the elements like I did in a little bit over here. So I did something like this. I put array sub I, then plus the index. So now the index is j, and we want to dereference it. So put a parenthesis and a star. Build and run. And yes, we have our values. Perfect. Now, let's dereference this over here using the parenthesis. So we put parenthesis, the name of the pointer or the array, and plus the index. So plus I. And of course, over here we have star. Build and run. Perfect. We have our values. This is the same thing we done before with pointers when we were working with a 2D array, right? And I hope now things are being easy for you. And now let's use this over here. As you can see, we are getting the element, then we are getting the address. So let's remove the address and let's think about this. This is our pointer. So I want to reach my pointer and then I want to reach the element, right? So if we put this only, we will be getting the address. So this over here gives me my pointer, right? So to move along the columns, I have to add the index of the column. So put the j over here. So now I have my pointer. I'm dereferencing the row, but I'm not dereferencing the column. So this over here will give me the address of the column at the j position. So first of all, the first column, then the second column. Let's try this. Build and run. Put some numbers. And yes, we have what we want. Perfect. Now, let's say we don't want to use these brackets. So these brackets over here are dereferencing our row. So we already know to dereference our row, we do the following. In parentheses, we add the name of our array or the pointer to the index of our row and we put star. So this is how we dereference our row. So this will give us the same thing that we did from a little bit. Build and run. Perfect. Look, everything is working. So this is it. And now we still have to free each array. So copy this. And in here, we will iterate over the elements and free each one. So array sub I. Perfect. So this is it for this video and I'll see you in the next one.